It was fairly easy. Silva, even though he's manic and in your face, he's also kind of very smart and calculated when he's in combat. So I didn't have to do that much, you know? I mean, I did a lot of stuff with the weapons. I had a couple of fight scenes in the bakery and then in the building. But for me, it was easier, you know? Ico was the one who had to do all the tough stuff and most of the fighting, and Lauren. So, you know, you'd have to ask them. For me, it was a more of a walk in the park. The dialogue and the energy and the intensity that was really kind of, that I had to focus on every day. I had to really be on. You know, we always call Silva, he's the lighthouse. You know, he's always on. So that was the trying thing for me. Because by the time I worked out, played golf, went to work, I was already tired.
I think our training was really fun. I remember that yesterday when you said about the hotel, because we got to go into an abandoned hotel to practice and, you know, like ground to standing to transitioning between all this different gear, and then being in the film learning to run with just like huge heavy backpacks, jumping in and out of cars. I realize I'm not picking one scene. That's basically why.
The fire. They set everything on fire. It was great.
Real fire. We had so many practical effects in the film.
Yeah. I don't know if there's any CGI, to be honest. I spend most of the time with flame retardant in my hair. We like completely sweat through. We had to get to a point in the day where you couldn't tell that we were sweaty because we sweat all the way through our outfits.
Yeah. We changed the color of our clothing.
And we're talking like jeans. Like, it looked like we jumped out of a pool.
Oh, we're always doing all kinds of terrible stuff to each other. Leaving nasty things in our trailers and throwing stuff at people, dressing people up in crazy outfits, shaving my friend's eyebrows, making him run through this entire building with bare feet and carrying a small goat, and acting like we were filming it, but the camera was never rolling. Painting his teeth pitch black.
Maybe we didn't even know there were pranks.
Oh, Ico.
No, I'm just kidding. It's Ico.
Ico and his team. There were some great pranksters.
Yeah.
But he had a thing of like surprising me all the time. Like, he would sneak up on me and like get me to jump, and like, yeah, that was.
I forgot about that. Like, legit Busquets. Like, really.
Busquets.
Busquets.
I never heard that before. Yeah, oh yeah, you're an MTV UK, so I guess that's Busquets happens all the time. It's new for me.
Well, every day we're cutting up and laughing and playing pranks on each other, you know, Pete and I. There were a couple of days, you know, I think Colombia, as much as I loved being there, it was tough because I never went more than a week without seeing my family, and that was 3 weeks, and we were shooting 6 day weeks. So I was starting to get annoyed. I thought Pete was like, oh God, I better get him out of here. No, well, $6 billion man. But that's a guy who is chosen to be in this program, not his choice. And that's something we've been developing. Hopefully we'll be shooting that in the UK in the spring.
About 50,000%, if that's a thing, didn't even, that's why it was so fun to watch the finished product, because we were like, wow, the remaining footage could make, you know, the quadrilogy, whatever you call when it's four movies.
four movies. I got to serenade
you.
Oh,
the singing!
I had to learn a song and sing, and I'm terrible at singing, but I sang for her, and that was sweet.
And it's not in the movie.
No, because it wasn't intense enough. Oh, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot. I know, I love the words.
Yeah.
We could have like, everything's happening, other things happening, time for a song. And then we're going again, you know, like I wouldn't have.
Yeah. You should have been singing while shooting.
And then, like, that's right, dang.
Next one, the sequel.